Hello students, today we are going to learn chemical properties of metals under the lesson metals and non-metals. So let us start with our topic. Under the topic of chemical properties of metals, we will learn some important reactions of metals with oxygen, water, acids and bases and salt solutions. Today in this lesson, we will cover the reactions of metals with oxygen. Actually, almost all metals react with oxygen to form metal oxide. But the rate with which a metal reacts with oxygen tells us about its reactivity. For example, some metals react with oxygen even at room temperature, while some require heating for the reaction to happen. And there are some metals which do not react with oxygen even on strong heating. So let us discuss this in detail. First of all, we'll take example of sodium and potassium. Sodium and potassium are two metals which react with oxygen very vigorously even at room temperature. When they are kept in open, they catch fire and form their oxide. That is why they are stored in kerosene so as to prevent their reaction with air. Now we will write the reaction of potassium and sodium with oxygen. Molecular formula of potassium is K. It will react with oxygen present in air at room temperature to form its oxide K2O. The molecular formula of potassium oxide will be K2O because oxygen has valency 2, whereas potassium has valency 1, they will interchange and the formula will become K2O. Whenever we will write a chemical equation, we have to write a balanced chemical equation. So after writing the skeletal equation, we need to check whether each atom of every element is balanced both the sides or not. Now here we can see oxygen atoms are 1 at right hand side, but they are 2 at the left hand side. Same way, potassium is also not balanced. So in order to balance it, if we write 4 here and 2 at the front of K2O, we will get a balanced chemical equation. Similar reaction will happen with sodium. Sodium molecular formula is Na, oxygen is O2. They will react to form Na2O, that is sodium oxide. Reaction is not balanced, so we will balance it by writing the coefficient 4 here and 2 here. Now, next metal is magnesium. Magnesium also reacts with oxygen to form its oxide, that is magnesium oxide. But this reaction does not take place at room temperature. It requires heating. So on heating, magnesium catches fire and it burns with a bright dazzling flame. And at the end, once all magnesium is burnt, we get a white powder. That white powder is actually magnesium oxide. The reaction or equation can be represented as Mg plus O2 gives MgO. Again, we need to write the correct molecular formula of magnesium oxide by interchanging the valency. Now, if we see the reaction is not balanced, so in order to balance it, we will have to write 2 here and 2 here. Now, since magnesium does not react with oxygen at room temperature, it requires heating. This suggests that magnesium is less reactive than potassium and sodium. After this, we have the metal aluminium. Aluminium also will react with oxygen and it will burn to form aluminium oxide. Formula will be Al2O3. This reaction happens less readily than magnesium. So we can say aluminium is less reactive than magnesium. We have to balance this equation now. So now we can first we'll balance oxygen. We'll interchange the subscript. So here we will have to write 3 and here we will be writing 2 and 4 will come here. This is the balanced chemical equation for reaction of aluminium with oxygen. Now we will be seeing reaction of zinc, iron and copper. Zinc also will react with oxygen to form its oxide, zinc oxide, but it requires strong heating. This again suggests that zinc is even less reactive than magnesium and aluminium. It will burn in presence of air to form zinc oxide. Formula of zinc oxide will be ZnO because both zinc and oxygen have valency 2. So the valencies will interchange and since they are having common factor 2, so will be cancelled and will get a formula ZnO. We have to balance now. Here oxygen are 2 atoms at the left hand side and here only 1. So we'll have to write 2 here and 2 at the left hand side. Now we will discuss reaction of iron and copper. Both iron and copper require strong heating for reacting with oxygen. Both of them do not burn on heating, but they will form their corresponding oxides. So let us write reaction of iron with oxygen. Iron reacts with oxygen to form a mixture of iron 2 and iron 3 oxide, that is Fe3O4. So Fe in solid state, when it is heated, it will react with oxygen to form Fe3O4. In order to balance it, we will have to write 3 here and 2 here. The equation is balanced. But if we sprinkle iron filling on the flame, burning flame, we see that iron filling start burning, they catch fire. But if we heat a piece of iron instead, it will not burn, but it will react with oxygen to form this mixture of oxide. Now coming to copper. Copper on strong heating in presence of oxygen will form copper oxide, which is black in color. So when this reaction happens, we see the surface of copper gets covered with a black coating, which is of copper oxide. Now this equation is right now unbalanced. We have to balance it. So we'll write 2 here and 2 also at this side. There are some more metals like gold, silver, platinum. These metals do not react with oxygen even on strong heating. So finally, what we can conclude that these three metals, silver, gold and platinum, are even less reactive than whatever all metals we just now discussed. So based upon all these reactions, we can now arrange all these metals discussed in decreasing order of their reactivity. So let us write that order. The order will be potassium most reactive, then sodium, then magnesium, after that will come aluminium, then zinc, then iron, and at the end, or not end, copper, and the least reactive will be silver, gold and platinum. So that's all for today. I hope this lecture will be helpful to you all. Next time we will discuss the reactions of metals with water. Thank you very much.